Action Comics number 1060, Into the Abyss with John Constantine. So this book, I opened it up, and right off the bat, let me tell you that the book has more of other characters than Superman himself. Superman's in it, and I'm grateful that he's mostly illustrated by the great Ed Burroughs and Philip Kennedy Johnson. This guy, he's a proven writer. He's currently doing good stuff on the Incredible Hulk, but he really makes weird choices. The first thing I'm gonna say is that this book is a bait and switch. You see this? This is Superman and this is John Constantine. While they are featured in it, and while we do get stuff from it, this book is all about the angry females, about the strong female types, the bosses, we continue in comic books with the woke agenda, and I'm not sure what's going on, obviously I don't think DC Comics wants guys to be the main audience, the main fans of comic books anymore. I don't think they want fans like me who have been buying comic books and collecting them for, years and over decades and stuff. So yeah, we have mega powerful chicks like this one, Sister Shadow, who's just a ridiculous character. She's mad. I don't know why she has it against Superman. She's obviously a villain, but she's all over the place. And let me show you what I'm talking about. Like over here, don't talk to me of heroes, girl. Mine is the line of Wayne and of the Al Ghuls. So she kidnapped this little girl who has powers. Her name is Othora. Superman adopted her, and Superman's worried. He's looking for her. This Sister Shadow took her, and let's continue. I'm called Sister Shadow. I kill heroes and tyrants, lanterns and dark stars, new gods and old. My family brought absolute peace and order to scores of Earths, hundreds of Earths, civilizations beyond counting. Okay, so this is a mouthful over here. So she is from Wayne's, and I'm guessing, this is the DC Universe. So we're talking about Bruce Wayne. We're talking about Batman. And you see the Batman figures behind her. And the Al Ghuls. Batman and Al Ghuls in a regular world are basically enemies. There was a romance, and there's an offspring, Damian, and from Talia al Ghul and Batman, and but not, this is different. This is, she's Sister Shadow is from alternate Earth, and but listen to what she's saying. She's saying, don't talk to me of heroes, girls. Mine is the line of Wayne and all the Al Ghuls. So yeah, maybe the Waynes are heroes, but not the Al Ghuls, right? So she has killed heroes and tyrants. Heroes and tyrants are not the same thing. So it looks like Philip Kennedy Johnson is trying to say that heroes and tyrants, lanterns, dark stars, new gods, and old. These lanterns are not tyrants. Dark Stars were, you know, a police force. New Gods, yeah, there's evil ones and bad ones, and you know, Sister Shadow is that powerful. So she's talking about she's God level, right? Powerful. So she kidnapped this girl. She kidnapped her. And according to her, she has kidnapped Uthora for her own good, because Superman has, by adopting her, has stolen her potential. Because in some type of future, and then this, you know, this lady is obviously confused, because she's going after an alternate. A childhood alternate version of Uthora, not the Uthora she knew that will become, according to her. This is what you're meant to become, a conqueror, untamed and unspoiled, your arms wrapped in the bloody chain of the war Zoom, Valkyrie, general of the war world engines, a soul bearer of all green. So you see where I'm going. This is already, we have two Uthora who might become, will become some type of conqueror. I don't know why. And then we have Sister Shadow. You see? And it's all about this, you know, strong females in action comics. So when I bought the book, I bought it for Superman. Right? I bought it for Superman. The only kind of redeeming part is at least Supergirl's trying to be, you know, acts a little bit more kindly. And I'm pointing at her because she's a female. You see, what I'm trying to say here is that all the females in this book are fucking crazy. They are maniacs, they're evil, they're villains, or they will come villains of some type. They're all super powerful, they're all smarter, stronger, faster, they think better, and they do better than even Superman himself. And they question the presence of Superman, and they condemn the presence of Superman. And it's, you know, I don't understand why this is happening in Action Comics. Meanwhile, Superman and John Constantine, you know, they're trying to get to Uthora. And John Constantine, by the way, tells Superman to, you know, since he came to ask him for help, to allow him to take the lead and don't question his orders, and keep it calm. Don't talk to demons. We're gonna go to this part that looks like hell and all this shit. And the art is great. A little switch up, because this is not Eddie Barrow's art, but this is. So that kind of switch up in art is threw me off a little bit. The dialogue is also erratic at times, but there are very interesting visuals. It's entertaining at the very least. But here we go again. Suddenly, Superman panics. What are her way? There's no time. Arthur could be. Now you listen here. You pull me into this because you don't know squat about magic. There's that condescending again. Another character condescending. Superman and John Constantine, out of, you know, I guess he's hung over. Everybody sheds on Superman nowadays. It's ridiculous. I mean, John Constantine is a former teammate, huge member of the Justice League, dark section of the Justice League. He knows Superman. They've teamed up before. They have saved the world before. But here we are, taking the road through hell. There's always a toll for Superman. It is her. Arthur, where are you? It's a trick. Blue, super plug your super ears and let's get on. I'm here, Papa. And then, you know, Superman starts acting like a fucking idiot. Papa! She's in the hourglass. No, don't touch it. Also, whoever's voice you're hearing, it ain't your girl's. Ignore it. Please, Papa, help me. Don't touch anything. And then, you know, you see? So it's like, this is Superman. He has led the Justice League. Countless of times he has faced magical beings. He has faced wizards, gods, world conquerors, and he has experience. He knows these things. Why is Superman all of a sudden acting like a stupid idiot who has never had crossed paths with magic before, with magic threats? Why would he ignore John Constantine's instruction? You know why? Because the women, the female characters that DC Comics is pushing down our fucking throats, they want them to overshadow even Superman himself. That's why. So they do that bait and switch, you know, where that's it. And this is where the main storyline continues. So Superman, he ditched Constantine. Constantine's not with him anymore. And now another version of the demon and Bloodhound joins Superman. The story is kind of intriguing, but I just cannot unsee, you know, the pushing of this women in Action Comics, unbearable women characters that just don't make sense. And then we get this story where a character called Dreamer is featured in this Action Comics, and it's just nauseating. And then we get Amanda Waller, and Amanda Waller is this bitch that manipulates everybody, doesn't respect anybody, uses everybody as chess pieces. She comes looking for this Dreamer, and the story is about Dreamer and how better she is, how formidable she is, how strong she is. She dissed Superboy because she didn't need his help. She went to fight this baddie that can see 5 seconds into the future, and she fights him toe to toe, even though he's a man, even though he's physically stronger and faster, unless she's Wonder Woman level, or maybe she has super strength. I'm not sure, because I don't care about these fucking characters. I did not buy Action Comics for these characters. So it's, you know, so that's the third female character in this book that is being pushed down my throat. And then, you know, oh, we're gonna know about her later in Dream Team. And then I don't give a fuck. And I just, you know. And then we get the third story, where it's supposedly it's about Zod, but not really about Zod. It's about his, you know, his lesbian daughter. And it's like every traditional character, like Zod, Superman, Lex Luthor, they all have this angry, bitchy, lesbian type offspring going on. And it's just, I just don't get it, man. It's the, who is pushing this agenda? Who's in charge of DC Comics? Who is doing this? Who thinks this is cool? Who, you know, what kind of audience are you trying to bring? Look at this. Look at her haircut. And she looks like a fucking Nazi. And I guess that's the idea, because she's the daughter of Zod. And it's just, and I don't care. I didn't even read the story, to be honest. It's just, you know, and they always leave, you know, the worst art for the last story. This art is really, really awful. So that's, you know, that's my view. Action Comics number 1060. It's just a mess, convoluted mess. It's just the bait and switch. You know, Action Comics is not about Superman. It's about angry females. And they're all very powerful, more powerful than Superman himself. They're smarter. They're angrier. They don't like men. They are better than men. And they will all be queens and conquerors. And they will be better than gods and Green Lanterns and Dark Stars and better than everything ever made by other male writers in the history of DC comic books. That's just the way I look at it. And I'm sorry to say, this is probably the last issue of Action Comics I'm buying, because obviously, you know, I'm not that type of fan that DC Comics wants anymore. You know, the male type, the guy type. So there you go. That's my view. Let me, give me likes, dislikes. Please subscribe to my channel. Give me some comments and let me know what you thought of Action Comics. And maybe you say something that'll change my mind and will make me keep buying it. Thank you guys for listening to me. Peace.